Hi, my name is Jihad Gündüz, I'm a developer of RemafoX, and in this video I'm going to show you how to set up a project in RemafoX, and I will quickly walk you through the most important configuration options. When you open RemafoX, you'll be greeted by the Projects browser. To set up your project, press the Setup New Project button. Then, simply drag and drop your project folder into the window. RemafoX will now analyze your project files to find good defaults for you. Once this has completed, you'll be presented with the quick config form. This is a mini version of the configuration file we'll see at the end of the process. Check that your project name, the Xcode project, and the source language are correct. Then make sure to prepend the path of your code files to the resource enum file path field. This is a file automatically generated by RemafoX for safe access to strings in code. It will provide auto-completion support for strings to make typos in strings keys impossible. In my case, all code lies within the path app/sources, so let's prepend that. After pressing continue, RemafoX will generate the file and show instructions to link it. If you're setting up a SwiftPM framework, you can skip this step. SwiftPM will find the file for you. But if you have a normal app project like me, we need to drag and drop the file to our project. For our convenience, RemafoX provides a button to locate the file quickly. Let's press it. Now let's drag the file into our project and then press the next button. Here, RemafoX is telling us to check the box for our app target. If you have multiple targets where you need to access localized strings, check their boxes too. Let's finish the setup process, which saves the configuration file and opens it automatically. Now, let me walk you through the most important things you might want to configure here. First and most importantly, it is highly recommended to set up the build script in your project. The build script makes sure to run RemafoX on each build of your app to keep things updated. Press Setup Build Script and you will get step-by-step instructions how to set it up. I will just copy the script code from the first step by pressing Copy Code. Then, let's navigate to the Build Phases tab for our project in Xcode and press the plus button. Select New Run Script Phase from the dropdown. Rename it to RemafoX and move it up. Now let's open it, paste the script in, and uncheck the Dependency Analysis checkbox. That's it. Let's finish the build script guide and continue exploring the config file. Under Quick Actions, you'll find all the buttons doing something on the project in one place. These buttons are also available in these other configuration panes, so I'll explain them there. Under General, you'll find what we have already seen in the config form before. Under Search Paths, you can adjust where to search for strings files or storyboard and zip files. The paths you will see here are the ones RemafoX suggests based on its analysis during setup. By pressing Preview Matching Files, you can review which files the current paths would match. Under Generated Code, you can customize the generated Swift file for safe strings access. If you decide to move the file to a different location, make sure to set the new path here. It is recommended to keep the first four options as is, unless you really know what you're doing. If you're using RemafoX within a Swift package, make sure to select Swift package here. Also, you can adjust the indentation style to be used in the generated code to fit your project. By pressing Generate Enum File, you can manually trigger the generation of the Swift file. Note that the build script takes care of this already, so there's usually no need to trigger it here. Under Linter, you can adjust which safety checks should be executed on your strings files. Press Lint Strings Files to see if there are currently any issues in your project. Note that the build script takes care of this too. It shows issues as warnings right within Xcode. Under Normalizer, you can adjust which changes RemafoX should make to your strings files. If you applied your own grouping of keys in strings files, you should disable sort by keys. Press normalize strings files to execute the changes, but note that there is no undo button. So make sure to check in your strings files in version control before playing around with these. Note that the build script takes care of this too. Under machine translation, you can set up your API keys for the supported services. With at least one API key set up, you can trigger translating your entire app from the screen. Press the first button to translate only the strings that are empty and not translated yet. In our case, this fixed the problem with some empty translations we've had before. Note that the build script takes care of this too, if any API key is set up on a machine. You should be cautious with the second button. It will override all your existing translations. Under Interface Builder, you can adjust the extraction of strings from storyboard or zip files. The ignore flags can be used in the comments field of views to exclude them from extraction. This can be useful when you have a UI label where you want to set the text programmatically. Press update strings files from storyboard or zip files to trigger an update manually. But again, the build script takes care of this as well. That's why it is strongly recommended. One last thing you might want to do is to migrate any existing localization strings to a safe call. Let's open up the project and migrate the existing translations over to RemafoX calls. Use .string at the end of the calls unless you use SwiftUI previews with multiple languages. And that's it. We have set up and configured an entire project for use with RemafoX. But before you commit your changes, we have one last tip for a great onboarding experience of your team. To make everyone in your team benefit from RemafoX, we prepared a dedicated video for them. It only goes through the minimal steps needed for them to make full use of RemafoX. Add a link to that video in your existing onboarding process or simply to your README file. The video URL is 2.remafox.app/onboarding. You can add HTTPS in front if you like. Also, if you want all team members to be able to use machine translation services, don't forget to share an API key in a safe way. For security reasons, they are not part of the config file. With that, the setup is complete. For maximum benefits, make sure to watch the onboarding video yourself. If you come across any issues, or if you have questions, make sure to report them in the app's help menu. Thank you for watching.